everyone. So in today's video, you guys are going to watch me get ready for prom, and I'm actually getting ready to head out the door right now, so that's why I'm talking kind of fast because I'm running a little bit late as always. But this is the finished product. This is what my dress looks like. I'm gonna do some close-ups of it like at the end so you guys can see, but I will put a link to it down below if you guys want to know where it's from. This necklace is just my mom's and I thought it matched well, and then I just have some other like random accessories. Also, I wanted to mention that I got my hair done like at a salon, but I came home and I was kind of frustrated with how it looked. So I ended up like redoing it and doing it myself, and I didn't have time to film like a full in-depth tutorial for that, but I'm going to link one down below that you guys can watch. I basically just waterfalled it on each side and then I tied it like with an elastic in the back. So yeah, I'm sorry I couldn't film that for you guys, but I will put a tutorial to one that you can watch like down below if you're interested in learning how to do it. So I have to go off to prom now, but anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this video. If you do, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Comment down below when your proms are, and you know, let me know what your dress looks like and all that sort of stuff, because I'd love to know. And let's just go ahead and get started. Alrighty, so I started off by just pulling my hair back with a headband, and the first thing that I did was apply my Maybelline Baby Skin Face Primer all over my skin just to give a nice base for the rest of my makeup. And then I just went in with my Maybelline Age Rewind Concealer, which I love. It covers up basically everything, and I put that underneath my eyes as well as on like my chin and my nose and just where I had red spots, and I blended that all in with my Beauty Blender. So next I just went in with this L'Oreal foundation and I just kind of squeezed a little bit of this onto my face. And I realized once I was going back to editing this that it looked super yellow on my skin, but I promise in person it looked a lot better. I think it was just the lighting in this video. But I'm just blending that all the way out with my Beauty Blender, and I'm also using a foundation brush as well because I did not want my face to look cakey at all, so I just blended that all over. Next, I went ahead and filled in my eyebrows with my Anastasia Brow Powder Duo. And I'm just, you know, doing the basics, filling those in, and I also like to sort of brush through those afterwards. And then I went in with a clear mascara to sort of set those into place so that they would, you know, stay in place all night long. Moving on to powder, I'm using this new one by Milani, and it's supposed to be like a mattifying, full coverage powder, and I really like it so far, and I'm using it with like this little puff because I feel like that is what mattifies my face the most. I feel like that works better than just a brush for me, so I just applied that all over my face, and then I'm just using an eye primer to prime my eyelids before I put on eyeshadow. So then after this, I actually had to go and get my hair done while I was doing my makeup, so this is what it looks like. I know, kind of crazy, but don't worry, I fixed it later on. So then moving on, I went ahead and put on some bronzer, and I just did that in the normal areas and contoured my face. And here I am just using a highlighter from NYX, and this is, I believe, their Face Illuminator. It's a really pretty liquid highlighter, and so I just applied that to the tops of my cheekbones as well as to my temples and on my Cupid's bow, and this just gave a really pretty glow to my face. And then I used this really pretty pink blush by Milani. It's super shimmery and I thought it was perfect and it matched well with my dress. Now moving on to eyeshadows, I am using my Naked 3 palette, and I used this because I thought that the pink shades would match well with my dress again. And so I'm starting off with a light pink shimmery color called Burnout, and I'm putting that all over my lid with just a flat shader brush. And then I'm going in with a really light pink color that is matte into the crease, and it's called Limit, and it just kind of gave a nice defined look without being too dark or anything. I then took a dark shimmery brown color called Liar and put that into the very outer corner just to add a little bit of definition. And after blending all of that out, I went in with an even darker color in the very outer V, and here I am sneezing. Yeah, that's nice. And again, I just blended that out to make sure that there were no harsh lines. And I of course have to highlight underneath my brow bone, so I'm just doing that with a light shimmery white color.
And that is it for the eyeshadow, but now moving on to eyeliner, I'm using a black liquid eyeliner from Maybelline, I believe. And I just made a thin line on the top lash line and I winged it out just a little bit. And I didn't show you guys me doing the second eye, but I tried my best to show you the first one. And so after finishing the eyeliner, I went ahead and put on some false lashes. These ones are from Ardell. I've used them before and I really like them. You couldn't really tell that I was even wearing them in this clip, but I was. And then I just went ahead and used some mascara to sort of blend my fake eyelashes with my real eyelashes so they looked more natural. And then on my lower lash line, I just used a black pencil eyeliner to sort of darken that up a bit. And I also applied some mascara to my bottom lashes as well. And I didn't show myself applying this, but as for lips, I just used my Revlon lip butter in the color Berry Smoothie. I use that basically every day. And this was the finished product. This is what my hair looks like and my necklace and like my bracelets and everything. I will put links to everything in the description box down below if you guys are interested in where anything came from. So as for my hair, as you can see, it was curled and then I did like a waterfall braid on each side and I just sort of braided it back together. And I really like how it turned out once I like redid it myself. I didn't like it how the lady at the salon did it, but once I fixed it, I really liked how it looked. And this is what my shoes looked like. They were really casual sandals, but they were comfy and that's all that mattered. And yeah, that was all for this prom video. I really hope you guys enjoyed it. Be sure to give it a thumbs up if you did. I love you all so, so much, and I will talk to you very soon in my next video. Bye!